Like,
I look really comfy, don't I?
What's up? I'm Brian.
What's up? I'm Kevin.
Howie D.
I'm AJ.
I'm Nick.
So tell me about this style here. Is this the style for Backstreet, or is it self-created style, or is it natural style?
It's just something that we've collaborated with our stylists. Luckily, shooting videos and working together with our stylists, we've come up with sort of our own little thing combined with, I don't know, just nice, shiny, hip, cutting-edge stuff.
Casual.
Yeah, casual. Yeah. When it needs to be cash, it's cash. When it needs to be
dressy,
it's dressy.
It's whatever, exactly. Whatever suits the situation.
So you guys are all comfortable in front of the camera. Like, this is love the camera.
We're a bunch of hams.
I go a little higher, though.
Imposing, or used to posing?
Yeah.
Like, do you have a certain route that you go through when you're doing photo shoots like this? Like a mindset that you guys try to get in? Or?
Well, there's only... try to have fun.
Yeah. There's only so many poses and different things you can do with five O's at a time, so... I think we've been through all of them. So,
you know, we've created.
We're pretty professional when it comes
to. Kind of know it works.
Can you guys group together?
So,
And Teen Magazine. Now, this is a big market for you guys. I mean, it's kind of weird to be on the cover of Teen Magazines. And
it's just definitely a way to get your name out and get exposure.
It's a good start.
So now you guys are huge in Europe, right?
Not just Europe. I mean, luckily we've had a lot of success this last year and a half internationally. All throughout Europe, the Orient, and in Canada.
Give me an idea of how big you are.
Well, we're about ready to get to, we're about to go back to Europe and do some stadium tours. So 30 to 50,000 seaters. So it's pretty good on the status level.
It's about as big as you can get. 11 million copies of our records. So.
So you're big with like screaming teens, a lot of fans, a lot of people recognize you on the streets.
It's a riot. It's a riot. Over in Europe, it's funny because we used to call the U.S. no fan land. We would come back here from like over in Europe or Asia or wherever we're coming from. And it would just be really laid back and calm. It's kind of a place for us to get away from. And you go back over to Europe and you can't go anywhere without having a security guard or planning where you're going to go. And it's fun though. I mean, we all love it. We love the attention.
Los Backstreet Boys arrasan entre las más jovencitas y su música es ya todo un éxito.
We've been working a long time for this, and now that it all happened,
hemos trabajado durante mucho tiempo para conseguir esto. Lo que pasa es que ha ocurrido todo muy deprisa. Pero detrás de ello hay un trabajo duro. La gente considera que somos distintos por ser famosos, pero seguimos siendo tan normales como antes.
A pesar de su corta edad, AG, Brian, Nick, Howie y Kevin tienen muy claro lo que quieren conseguir.
Con nuestra música queremos que la gente sea feliz, porque pensamos que con lo que hacemos se puede conseguir. Y además con ello nos divertimos y también nuestros fans.
Por ello han decidido contraatacar. Su nuevo trabajo saldrá pronto al mercado. La música absorbe gran parte de su tiempo, pero ellos están llenos de vitalidad.
Echamos de menos el tiempo que no tenemos para estar con la familia, porque nos debemos a nuestras fans. Pero a pesar de todo, estamos muy contentos.
Sus visitas a nuestro país han sido relámpagos, pero esperan volver pronto porque están encantados con el público español.
Esperamos venir más a España. Ahora estamos preparando un tour por Europa que haremos entre agosto y septiembre. Vamos a intentar trabajar unos días más para poder cantar aquí, en España.
Los cinco son amantes del deporte y los videojuegos, y cómo no, de las chicas.
No tenemos tiempo para tener novias ni nada serio con las chicas, porque con nuestro trabajo es difícil mantener una relación de este tipo.
Howie nos confesó estar enamorado de Cindy Crawford, pero ¿qué les parece las españolas?
Son muy guapas.
Muy bonitas.
Así son los Backstreet Boys, un grupo lleno de ritmo que ha sabido conquistar el corazón de más de una jovencita.
Me llamo AJ.
Hola, me llamo B-Rock.
Hola, me llamo Nick.
Hola, yo soy Javier.
¿Qué tal? Me llamo Kevin.
Y somos los Backstreet Boys.
Saludos a las fans.
¿Qué me dices?
der Fans.
Backstreet Boys bei der Konzertvorbereitung. Howie steht am Bügelbrett und macht seine Jeansfalten frei für den Auftritt. Nick döst noch ein wenig vor sich hin und Sunny Boy Brian geht seiner Lieblingsbeschäftigung nach, Mädchen ärgern. Immer wenn er sich am Fenster zeigt, drehen seine Fans durch. Einen ganzen Nachmittag lang, so oft er will. Immer wieder feuern sie die Boys an, sich am Fenster zu zeigen. Wenn es dann endlich geschieht, fließen Freudentränen. Das ist schon ein Riesenandrang da draußen. Ich kann es auch nicht erklären. Das ist wirklich ein Phänomen. Man bekommt da ein ganz komisches Zucken im Bauch. Das ist sehr aufregend. Manchmal gehen wir nach den Konzerten in den Erste-Hilferaum und begrüßen die Mädchen kurz. Das hat sich wohl herumgesprochen und so gibt es immer einige, die so tun, als wären sie ohnmächtig. Aber wir hassen es, wenn die Mädchen aus dem Konzert getragen werden müssen. Doch auch gestern Abend müssen die Boys den verhassten Anblick ertragen. Ein Mädchen nach dem anderen wird aus dem Saal getragen. Die, die zumindest eine Zeit lang ihren Sonderplatz in der ersten Reihe verteidigen können, sind überglücklich. So nah dran waren sie noch nie.
Eingequetscht, aber es ist so geil! Das ist super, aber es ist ein bisschen eng, aber macht nichts. Dafür tut man alles.
Aber es ist nicht nur die blinde Begeisterung für die schönen Jungs, es geht auch um tiefe Gefühle und wahre Liebe. Eine letzte Chance gibt es noch, die Jungs zu sehen. Nach der Show fliehen die Backstreet Boys in ihrem Bus. Als die Fans erkennen, wer ihnen da gerade hinter den abgedunkelten Scheiben zuwinkt, drehen sie wieder durch. Es ist ein unvergessliches Erlebnis für alle Mädchen, die den Abend bei Bewusstsein erlebt haben.
Nick's glasses. We've seen him with glasses. Some fans have seen him with glasses, and I'm like, I don't know. So I've seen him with, like, you know, regular glasses on. Does he have to wear glasses or what?
No, you know? Actually, he got it from me. Because I used to wear, like, I wear sunglasses all the time anyways, but once in a while I would wear, like, the little button, like the bifocals, I guess you can call them. And Nick, I guess when he puts on a really nice outfit or a suit, puts his hair back, puts on the glasses, and becomes a full adult. It's like a transformation thing, you know, from baseball cap to glasses. And, yeah, the whole Leonardo DiCaprio thing is going on.
Full of high energy, pyrotechnics, dancing, live 6-piece band, live vocals.
Coming back home, I mean, number one, it's like a dream come true to us. I mean, just to be able to do these size arenas and to perform for all the fans who have supported us over the years since 1993. Oh, baby, you're so fine.
I feel we're getting better vocally. I think we're getting better as far as writing and our lyrics. I think we're getting better as far as performers as well. So hopefully it's just going to continue to grow, and that's what we want to do, continue to grow and continue to get better.
Getting ready to open our biggest tour we've ever branched across America, and it's really hard to believe. I sit here, coming out of heart surgery, I want to first and foremost thank all the fans, my family at home. A lot of prayers have been answered, a great doctor, and a lot of support from a lot of people. And I wouldn't be sitting here if I didn't have that behind me. And I want to thank each and every person that played a big role in that. On the lighter side, I'm feeling great. I've got an A book of health from my cardiologist in Orlando, Florida. So I'm back to work with the guys and appeasing all the fans out there to see what they want to pay the ticket to come see. So it's exciting. I'll never let you go, no, no. Wherever I go, whatever I do, Charlotte. Like I said, this is an actual 2.5-month tour. It's going to cover all across America. We're going to go up to Canada and then come back down the East Coast. We're going to hit pretty much venues similar to this, arenas, normally around 10,000 seaters, which we've been very fortunate to sell out most of them. And we're very excited to be back in America. Backstreet's back.
No, we just rehearsed. We just practiced rehearsing. So,
hi, we're gonna piece by piece.
Yeah. Okay. Cool. Then we go.
Ready?
I'm just vocal rehearsal. 1, 2, 3.
You're watching us here on the big head.
Holla at you, boys and girls.
You're watching us. Here on the big head.
All right,
thank you.
You're watching us here on the big head. You're watching us here on the big head.
Hi, we're Backstreet Boys. Sorry we couldn't be there with you live in person. Let's do that again. You know what they're gonna do with these? They're gonna do like the mess up thing. He's gonna be like, yeah. Ready? 1, 2, 3.
You're watching us here on the big head.
Hi, we're the Backstreet Boys. And we're sorry that we couldn't be there in person. But right now we're cutting tracks for the new album. So kind of busy.
Guys, let's tell them what the big help is all about.
Well, what is it?
It's a park thing.